Black Friday sales seem to grow both in length and volume every year. This year's event started earlier than ever on Thanksgiving Day in many places. Still, Friday's crowds were large, with reports of orderly calm in some cities like Washington, D.C., near bedlam in others. Lines of eager shoppers stretched around stores nationwide as the hunt for Black Friday discounts went into overdrive.
That 40-inch TV, that's costing me $200 only.
This is perfect. It has 100 pieces for 10 bucks. You can't beat that.
$10 waffle iron. We got a Dutch oven for 40 bucks.
But this year, the traditional kickoff to the holiday shopping season was a marathon two-day event for many merchants. More than two dozen national retailers like Best Buy and Target opened doors yesterday on Thanksgiving, offering customers a head start on the binge buying. Kmart was one of the earliest, opening at 6 a.m. Thursday.
I'm in!
Toys R Us, 5 p.m.
For Black Friday, it's clearly a big electronics day, so we've seen a lot of action in tablets. We have over 20 tablets on sale.
And at Macy's flagship store in New York City, more than 15,000 people waited in line for its 8 p.m. opening last night, the first Thanksgiving Day hours ever in the chain's 155-year history.
I've never seen anything like it, and I've been at every single one of our openings since my career began.
Many retailers said it was a response to demand.
We've had a lot of feedback from our customers, and they want us to be open as soon as possible.
This is about serving our customers at a time when they have asked us to.
But the early openings met with resistance from workers, labor rights groups, and even shoppers themselves, who said the early start times ruined the holiday.
I think it's horrible. Thanksgiving's a day to spend with your family.
Some franchise owners, like Holly Cassiano, who owns a Sears in New Hampshire, refuse to open early.
We're not going to allow corporate retailers to rule over our family values.
In locations across the country, workers protested against the expanded holiday hours. Walmart was a particular target. Some employees of America's largest civilian employer picketed, calling for higher wages in Secaucus, New Jersey, and elsewhere. And outside an Ontario, California Walmart, a man dressed as Santa Claus was arrested as part of the protest. Meanwhile, retail experts question whether the early openings actually lead to increased Black Friday spending. Sales for the last 2 months of the year are up compared to a year ago, but still shy of holiday shopping surges seen prior to the recession. The National Retail Association expects sales to jump 4% to a figure above $602 billion. Still, this year's buying extravaganza did not pass without incident. Frenzied shopping led to fistfights. Scuffles broke out inside multiple big box stores from North Carolina to Texas.
It was a big old brawl. I guess they got kicked out or whatever, and they didn't get their TVs anyway, so it really doesn't matter, which is crazy.
And police responding to an alleged shoplifting at a Chicago area store shot a driver seen dragging a fellow officer with his car. Both were taken to a hospital with non-life-threatening injuries.